Big story tonight in the red hot race to replace Trent Franks after he resigned amid a sexual harassment scandal.
This happening in Congressional District 8, which includes Glendale, Peoria, Sun City. But the top issues on the campaign trail tonight, not the economy or the border, it's sex and money.
ABC 15's Melissa Blasius with the new allegations facing top candidates that voters need to know about.
The vote to replace Trent Franks on Capitol Hill seems more like a race to the bottom today. Steve Montenegro, a former state legislator and married minister, skipping public appearances. He calls allegations against him false tabloid trash. A third party is circulating flirty text messages purportedly between a low-level state government worker and Montenegro, including late-night texts while Montenegro was out of town and a topless selfie of the staffer. Former Governor Jan Brewer blasting Montenegro on social media, telling him to deny, confess, or withdraw.
That's a call for Steve to make and the district voters to make on him. He hasn't done anything illegal. Some people might say it's immoral. It's certainly more salacious than the clearly illegal activities that Debbie Lesko's campaign has been involved in.
Phil Lovis, another top candidate in the race, filed former complaints against Debbie Lesko with the Federal Election Commission and the state attorney general. Several people now allege she tried to skirt campaign finance laws and money from her old state campaign fund was improperly funneled through a political action committee to directly benefit her congressional race.
And they willfully flouted the law. And quite frankly, we don't need more swamp monsters going to Washington.
Lesko's campaign sent ABC 15 a legal opinion claiming there was no improper coordination between campaigns. The primary vote in the West Valley Congressional District is next Tuesday. Melissa Blasius, ABC 15, Arizona.